tracks of time moving in sequences, unfolding in regular patterns. The feeling of being in a groove to find the connection, to train like training wheels, to feel the balance and sense that at some point I want to pull out, get out of the groove and find something else. I want the freedom. Ritual brings that pattern of going into groove and out of groove more into the awareness. To know when there is contact, when there is freedom. And notice that freedom without contact, freedom without structure, freedom without the groove allows something different. It is necessary, but only half of the necessity to return back to the discipline of knowing what is the impact, what is actually connected, how does it work, and to break the reliance on that regularity, step into a world and out of a world in order to recognize the world that I'm in and the choicefulness of that at all times.
Ritual repetition. The oxen pull the plow and deepen the groove. Repeat the groove at the right time, every season, so you can plant the seeds and water the crops. Perform the ritual. Follow the cycle, the ritual cycle. Follow the flow. Dig the groove and let the water flow. The brand of the ritual, burning away the excess, burning away the burden so that one may flow freer in the groove. Ritual as a switch on a train track. Switch from this groove to the next. Train tracks spiraling around a sphere. Switch to a groove above or a groove below. The freedom to groove. Being trapped in another person's groove. The use of ritual to control, to keep players in tiny little cycles, removing their agency, preventing the players from creating their own games through restricting rituals.
Movement, repetition into a flow. Break the resistance to repetition such that repetition flows without resistance and becomes free. The flow moving through the body all the way to the connection point. To actually remember that I had forgotten what connection felt like. Apparent freedom that I thought I had was really the lack of discipline. Now that I find the discipline, I can guide the flow. We move from one track to another track, from one branch of the fractal to another branch of the fractal, exploring from the known into the unknown. Without the groundedness of understanding, I am lost in the unknown and swept away by the flow. When I have the orientation to plant my feet into the furrows at various scales, I'm able to dance with the flow, to surf into the deepest unknown and return back to the sense of here and now at any moment. Here and now is the deepest ritual part of the connection that allows the blossoming of the seeds that I planted.
Fractal flow. Fractal ritual, fractal game. All contained within one great metagame. The flower dances subtly with the way the rain and the wind and the sun fall upon it. This weight pushes the flower's roots into the ground. The fractal flow of the flower, the microcosmos of the weather above, the balance of flow within each player, recreating an embodied flow where the channels reach out to every edge of the membrane. The whole body is nourished by the flow. Instead, ritual violence generating trauma. Unritualized violence generating trauma. Ritual violence, when well contained, can sublimate violence, integrate violence into the core, give one a deeper understanding. Accept violence as a part of oneself rather than a destructive force coming from outside or from the outside within.
Structures of their own to allow the expression. The mold is just the starting point. The repetition gives perception to see what there is that is unseen. Into and out of recognizing the importance of the pause, the silence. I recognize the metabolization of silence into new form, and to not be addicted to the form, to allow that, just as the Tibetan monks do, the great mandala made of sand, fully ritualized in its absolute detail, and then swept away at the end as if nothing, only to start again. What is reaped from this practice isn't the object to be contained, but the growth of a self into something that can release and become something new, to be reborn.
enactment of the fundamental dimensions of being, the present, the past, the future, violence, death, murder, birth, intergenerational connection, transmission of ritual down ancestor to ancestee. Communally giving birth to a simulated past, present, and future. Simulating birth and death, so one remembers what one is always forgetting. Ritual as rites of passage to imprint at a young age the fundamental concepts so one never forgets, never forgets, never forgets. Otherwise, one has to spend a life of repetition to try and recover what one could have become if one had been well initiated into being. Rituals and games. Rituals as acting out being. Games as playing with being. Actors participating in rituals. Agents participating in games.
Swinging back and forth in the monotony, in the hypnosis, the silence brings forth that forgetting is fractal. Never forget that forgetting is essential. The forgetting of forgetting is the always knowing. Not by dint of memorization, but by dint of exploration. Every moment, the groove becomes more than shackles to bind, but the basis and platform on which to stand, to riff and play and ride the waves, like Shaun White riding those magnificent bulls, that whiteboard snowboard, playing in and amongst and finding the crevices unknown within the groove, in its first crudité, now becomes exquisite detail. The room to move inside of the
on every moment of giving birth to leaves, to petals, to pollen, with a deep trust, a faith that nourishes when one forgets, that is forgetting. A positive forgetting. A forgetting and a remembering simultaneously. A remembering of one's membership in the unknown, in the mystery, and faith in the mystery. Ritual to give birth to the mystery. Ritual to let the mystery return from whence it came. The great crime against humanity, the murder of mystery.
Presence is always possible. Disconnection is never truly possible. As one finds the way through the discipline of following this simplest motion, the following of a breath, the attention exquisitely focused here and now, in the silence of that revelation, becomes the depth of millennia and eons. The fractal reveals itself in whole. It's impossible to get to the finest detail or to the grandest, letting go of the attachment to any of it allows the flowering of all of it. The petals find their fractal way to express uniquely, no self-similar, reminding we are all here.
Enlightenment is that balance of attachment and non-attachment, the correct flow of attachment and non-attachment, that sine wave fluctuating at exactly the right frequency at whatever time. In one single breath, on the in-breath and the out-breath, connecting and disconnecting, attaching and detaching. Creating the rituals to attach and detach in this fractal manner, rituals that last minutes, that last hours, that last days, that last years, that last decades, that last a whole lifetime. The maintenance of the state of the ritual, of that sacred space. Maintaining that awareness, that attachment, detaching, whilst attaching to something so great, so sublime. So one detaches from everything else to attach to that. Attach to the detachment, detach from the attachment.